Hello friends, welcome to this video. In this video session, I am going to teach you how to take fungal extracts and what and all are the methods of taking fungal extraction and what are the uses of taking fungal extraction. So before moving into the actual video or actual demonstration, why do we need to take fungal extract or what is fungal extract? So as we all know, fungus body is in the form of hyphae or mycelium, which are thin thread-like filamentous body, filamentous structure they have. They will produce certain metabolites, they will be producing polysaccharides will be produced, they are called as secondary metabolites, and they are having various commercial importance, medical uses are there, applications are there, lots and lots of applications are there in the industries, pharma sectors, agro industries and all, we all know that. So now how do we extract that from the fungal hyphae or the fungal mycelium, and for what purpose do we do that? So one very important thing for what we can do is, for example, if you are working on GCMS or HPLC and you want to know what is the range of metabolites that is produced. If that particular metabolite is produced in higher concentration or is it produced in lower concentration, or if you want to take fungal extracts and you want to do total phenolic estimation, antioxidant activity, total protein estimation, proline estimation. So if you want to do any biochemical assays or if you want to give the sample for any other metabolite content, for metabolite screening, then you need to take fungal extracts. We all know that. Now for that you need to have a fungal growth. So we will inoculate the fungal in the suitable media like potato dextrose media or rose bengal media. So whichever your fungal organism grows in, so you will inoculate them and you will leave it around 2 days, 3 days. So depending on what fungal you are working and how much time period it is required for its luxuriant growth. That is very important. For its luxuriant growth, if it requires 4 days, you will leave it 4 days at 37 degrees Celsius at or lesser temperature, you will leave it. Usually we keep for fungus the temperatures around 25 to 27 degrees Celsius, we will maintain it. So now the fungus is ready. Now fungus body is in the form of hyphae or mycelium. So now what we will do is, we will pour this into a strainer or filter like this. You can use a simple coffee strainer or a filter strainer like this, and you will pour this entire media into this. Once you pour this, what happens, you will get the mycelium gets filtered over here. So all the liquid particles, your media particles will go there, and only your hyphae or your mycelium will be there in the, as a filtrate will be there, it will be there in the strainer over here. That you will wash it with distilled water, 2 to 3 times you will wash it with distilled water. Why we are using distilled water to wash this is, they will be having certain media components. If they are growing in potato dextrose media, they will be having certain saccharides will be there, starch material will be there, certain other chemicals, calcium will be there, nitrogen will be there. So we don't want the media components to interfere with our experiment. So as much as possible, we need to wash the media components. So once I filter it, I will wash it with distilled water, then I will collect this fungus biomass, we call it as, we collect the biomass, it is called as fresh weight of the biomass, we will measure it and we will put them in the petri plates and we will keep it, we will spread them in the petri plates and we will keep it in hot air over around 40 to 45 degrees Celsius. It is advised not to raise the temperature about 45 degrees Celsius because all the volatile compounds will be evaporated. We need all the compounds, whatever the fungus is producing, we need all the compounds for it. So it is advisable to keep the temperature range between 35 to 40 degrees Celsius. One special feature, characteristic feature of fungus is, they will produce the enzymes and metabolites even outside the body. So for example, if it is bacteria and some fungus, and almost all fungus will produce certain metabolites, certain enzymes outside the body also will be produced. So it depends on what type of work you want. If you want the compounds that are produced outside the body, outside the hyphae, then what you have to do, you have to centrifuge this. Once you centrifuge, all the filaments, all the hyphae will form pellet. You can wash that pellet once or twice with distilled water and you can collect the supernatant and you can evaporate the supernatant, or you can just use that supernatant as such for your any other experiments you can use. If you want both the metabolites in case of whatever is produced inside the body, intracellular products as well as extracellular products, then you have to do two set of experiments. So if you want extracellular products, centrifuge this entire along with the media, then it is difficult to separate the media components. Even the metabolites that are produced outside the body and the media components, both will be there. And if you are doing any elicitation studies, also we will use fungal extract. Let it be in vitro elicitation studies or in vivo if you are doing in poly house. If you want to give some biotic stress for the plant and you see, if you want to see the growth effect, or if you want to see the metabolite content with respect to stress, then biotic stress especially, you will add fungal extracts. Then if you add this along, if you centrifuge and add this along with the metabolites that are produced from the fungus, there are some chemical compounds that we are taking to make this media called PDA. So even they will interfere with the plant physiological process. So to avoid that, what I am taking here, I am only concerned about the metabolites and the enzymes that are produced inside the body. So I am going to filter it and I am going to show you now. So in this case, this fungus is non-harmful for me, so I am doing it outside the lab condition. But in your case, since it is a demonstration, it is just I am showing you, if you are taking any pathogenic fungal organism, then it must and should you have to use lab, you have to filter everything and you have to carry it all this process inside the lab laminar airflow itself you have to do. Since it is a non-pathogenic fungus and it is commercially useful, since it's an edible fungus, so I am just doing it in outside the lab condition. So using this coffee filter or strainer, I am going to take the fungus that has grown and I am going to filter them little by little only. It is possible since it is densely grown. So you can see the fungal hypha in this here, only the media components will come down. So there are two methods to do this. Either you can use this method where I have decanted the entire fungal growth into this filter and I am taking the filtrate, or there is another method where you can centrifuge and collect the pellet itself, you can do it. So I am just adding bit of distilled water to this itself. So whatever the fungus is there, fungal hypha is there in the flask, everything will come into this. This is one method where you can do it. It is most simplest method. The other method is whatever I had in this, the inoculum I had along with the broth, you can directly take it to the centrifuge tube. You can take it in 50 ml centrifuge tube and you can take for centrifugation. Once you do centrifugation, what happens? Whatever the pellets are there, that pellet is nothing but your fungal mass. So they will also be having certain metabolites will be there. So I will show you in both the methods, I will show you. So this is one method where I am filtering it and I am taking the fungal mass over here. This is one method over here. I will again show, again I will centrifuge this so that whatever pellets or whatever hypha has gone through this will be collected in my centrifugation process. So I will do both the methods and I will show you. So here I have collected the fungus growth over here in the centrifuge tubes. Now I will just run at centrifugation. If you are doing any enzymatic work, it is preferred if you are using ice cold centrifuge. If you are just working on the metabolites, then the normal centrifuge, ultra centrifuge is also fine. If you are carrying out enzymatic analysis, then you should use only ice cold centrifuge. Now I will just run at 5000 RPM for 5 minutes is so it's enough, so that all the hypha mycelium will form pellets at the bottom of the tube. So friends, I have shown you in two methods. First method of just isolating the hypha or mycelium, you can use it using a strainer or a filter paper. And the second method is using the centrifugation, where I just gave 5000 RPM for 5 minutes. So beautiful pellets has been formed over here. This pellet is the fungal mass. It is the hypha or the mycelium. And we don't need the supernatants, though the supernatant will be having some metabolites produced, some enzymes produced by the body, but they will also be having some contaminant like the media components will be there. Since I've used potato dextrose media, there will be some components of potato dextrose agar which will interfere with my experiment. So I don't need it, so I am not taking the supernatant, or else you can use the supernatant also for your estimation. So now just I will collect the pellet now. So you can decant the supernatant and you can just collect the pellet into a petri plate. So now you can also add bit of distilled water to the same thing without much shaking it, you can collect the, so just I'm washing with the distilled water with no much force I'm giving, so that all the media components comes off into the supernatant itself. Yes, so now the pellet, which is my pure fungal hypha, is ready. Now I will take a clean spatula and this is the fungal hypha. So this is the fungal hypha or the fungus mycelium which is required for my work. This I will take it into the petri plate and I will spread it so that it dries quickly. So in the petri plate I will spread it like this so that it dries. So you can see the fungal hypha or the fungal mycelium. So cleanly take out the everything. So same thing again in another centrifuge tube I had kept. That also I am going to do the same way. I am going to decant the media. First step, decant the media, then wash it with distilled water one or two times slowly. After washing with distilled water for 2-3 times, then you can take this pellet also. So this is your fungal hypha or the fungal mycelium and put it into the same petri plate. Spread it uniformly so that it dries quickly so that we get the dry biomass. So it will take, if you are keeping at 40 to 45 degrees Celsius, it will take some 3 days for its drying. So approximately I am saying it will take some 3 days. So same thing I am doing with another tube also. Decanting and I'm washing with this pellets with water. So after washing it with water several times, I'm just collecting the fungal growth. Such beautiful, luxuriantly the hypha has grown. See, so it is advisable to take more quantity of fresh weight after it dries, because we all know that all living organisms, water is the main component. After it dries, for example, if it is 5 grams, after it dries only 0.5 grams will come. So it is good that as much as you get, you can take that much. So 90 to 95% of the body is made up of water, let it be plant or animal or microorganism. So the same thing you can do it for your bacterial extract, same thing you can do for your algal extract. So whatever extract comes to you for your experiment using biotic elicitors for various biotic stress or to find the metabolite content of your extracts, you can use different solvents also for that matter. I am using water, which is a universal solvent. You can use methanol. Then if you are using methanol, only certain type of compounds which are soluble in methanol will be present in that solution. If you are using ethanol, chloroform, acetone, petroleum ether, so ethyl acetate, whatever extract, DMSO is also another good extract solvent. So water is considered as a universal solvent. So major of the compounds, most of the compounds will dissolve in the water and I will get a fungal extract. It is called as an aqueous extract. So now I am going to keep this in hot air oven for 40 degrees Celsius and I am going to leave it for a day, 2-3 days, so how much ever days it requires for drying, then I will show you how to proceed with. Okay friends, within 1.5 days to 2 days, you can see the extract that I showed you, it has become dried like it. So it took around 2 days completely to get a complete dried mass like this. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to scrap this out using a spatula or any sharp object and I'm going to take the dry weight. And then using this pestle and mortar, I'm going to powder it. So first let me scrap it out carefully. And see the dry mass of the fungal hypha. So now using the special motor, I'm going to crush it and take the dry weight of it.
Okay friends, now after we scrap out all the fungal mycelium from the petri plate, now I have collected the fungal mycelium. So how much ever you require, if you require more than 2-3 grams, then you have to continuously subculture them until you get enough of biomass. Now I have dried them and I have collected them in such falcon tubes. Now we are going to grind them using this pestle and mortar. So now I am going to put all this dried fungal extracts, fungal mycelium into a pestle mortar, and I am going to grind them into fine powder. So how much ever it is possible, as fine as possible, we are going to grind them. So since it is the dry powder, it will become very easy to grind. You don't have to put that much of efforts. So after it is done, so now the mechanical grinding is over. So this is called as mechanical grinding. So there are two methods in which you can prepare aqueous extract. So what do you mean by aqueous extract? I am using water as a solvent over here. So similarly, depending on the experiment that you are working, you can use chloroform, acetone, petroleum ether. So whichever solvent you want for your experiment, you can use that. But today's experiment, I'm going to use aqueous extract. So now, first method is, you can either while mechanical grinding itself using this pestle and mortar, we can add water or that respective solvent and grind them finely. That is one method. So for example, what is the ratio? We always take ratio 1:10. Let it be plant extract or fungal extract or bacterial biomass. If I am taking 1 gram of dry weight, I will take 10 ml of solvent. It can be any solvent. So this is the normal ratio that we follow. 1:10 ratio, we follow it. So now what I have taken? I have taken 3 grams of fungal extract. So I can add 30 ml of water. Not at once, little by little I can add, and I can grind them well, and then I can do this. So that is one method. So after grinding, so what I will do is, I'll take 30 ml of water, I will add little by little, and I will grind it, make it into a paste, and then I will transfer it, and I can leave it for overnight. Why do we leave it overnight? So for 24 hours we leave it, so that complete exudation of chemicals would have occurred. So I mentioned this even in while preparing plant extract, it is better to leave it overnight. And when you're leaving it overnight, please make sure you're keeping it in orbital shaker or some shaker, so that when the extract is shaking like this for overnight for 24 hours, all the phytochemicals would have released into the solvent. So that is one tip or trick you can use it. So leave it for overnight. Similarly, for example, I have taken 3 grams of fungal extract. I will add 30 ml of water and I will grind it well. I will make it into a paste. I will transfer this into conical flask, and I will cover the conical flask with aluminium foil, and I will keep it overnight for 24 hours in a shaker at 100 rpm or 120 rpm. You can set it and leave it. Then next day what you will do, you will centrifuge it. When you centrifuge, all the powder will become pellet and you will get a clear supernatant solution. That clear supernatant solution is your fungal extract. So that is one method. So you will just leave it overnight only by mechanical grinding, and then you will leave it overnight, centrifuge, and you will collect the supernatant as your extract. This is another method which I would like to show you all is, so there are many methods, whichever is beneficial to you, you can employ it. So this method is using an instrument called as homogenizer. So what is the principle of this homogenizer? You can see over here, it has sharp two pointed rods are there. So this will, when I keep this homogenizer into this extract, because of that high intensity of vibration, this will rotate. These two rods are there inside this. I hope you can see this. So two rods are there inside this. When I, this is connected by a power supply, when I put switch on the switch, there is RPM, so I can adjust the RPM. So RPM, it says that it can go up to 10,000 to 33,000 RPM. So that is the speed of this two rod. So when I put this inside this falcon tubes and I switch it on, and what will happen? Because of this high intensity, high rotations per minute, what will happen? All the cell will break over there and all the phytochemicals will come out of your fungal extracts, so fungal mycelium, fungal body, I can call it as body mass. So I would like to show you this method over here. Anyway, mechanical grinding also I explained, it is very simple. This is by using an instrument called as an homogenizer. So homogenizer, it comes in different sizes and different shapes it comes in. So this is one medium sized homogenizer. So let me show you how do we do this. And one more thing that I want to say you that instead of using just normal distilled water, for example, if you're doing aqueous extract, instead of using water, normal water, it is advised to use lukewarm water. The temperature should be around 40 to 50 degrees Celsius, not above 50 degrees Celsius. I'm not talking about boiling water because some metabolites, whichever is volatile, might have got volatilized. So you don't use very hot water. Use an hot or warm or lukewarm water, because some research paper suggests that whenever we use lukewarm water, more phytochemicals are extracted when compared to normal room temperature water. So what I am going to do over here, I am going to take normal water, distilled water, I am going to heat it and make sure the temperature is 40 to 50 and I touch, I should be able to bear that hotness, that is lukewarm water. Then in the ratio 1:10, since I have taken 3 grams, I am going to add 30 ml little by little. I am going to make a paste and I am going to transfer this into the Falcon tube, and then using this homogenizer, I will show you. So homogenizer also, there is another technique. You have to standardize the protocol. Some people use it for 30 minutes, some people keep it for 1 hour, some people keep it for 2 hours. So it depends upon what type of work you're going to do. Now in this, for my work, I'm going to keep it for 30 to 45 minutes. And also, please make sure you don't stretch it for 30, 45 minutes. Don't keep it once, because a lot of heat gets generated and your instrument also spoils and your extract also goes off because of the heat that is generated. So after 10 or 15 minutes, give a break for 5 to 10 minutes, let it come to room temperature, then keep it for another 10 or 15 minutes. So this 2 to 3 cycles I'm going to do, and then I'm going to keep it this also for overnight, so that I want all the phytochemicals, all the chemicals that is produced by this fungal mycelium to come into the solvent. So I'm making sure that complete exudation is happening. So I'm doing multiple things. I'm doing mechanical grinding, I'm using homogenizer for 30 to 40 minutes, then I'm leaving it overnight in the shaker. So when I do all these things, I can be sure, pretty sure, that all the phytochemicals has been exudated out. And then next step is I'm going to centrifuge it. So I made one video on centrifugation and using Wattmann filter paper, using Falcon tubes, all those things I have taught you. So I'm not going to show you the centrifugation part in this video. I'll give you the link, you can watch that. So after that, I'm going to centrifuge, I'm going to collect the supernatant, and that is my fungal extract. It is as simple as that. So let me just set up this in a homogenizer, then let me show you. So now for 3 grams, I have taken 30 ml of lukewarm water, so it is not boiling. I will just add little by little and then I will grind it again. So don't add all 30 ml at once, add little by little and grind it well. So as much you're grinding, that much phytochemicals or the biochemicals will be exudated out. So very good grinding should be done. So you can see here how well I have grinded it. So you're going to make it like a paste like this, make a fine paste by grinding it properly. So once it is made a paste like this, you can see it is, I made a proper paste. Now I will add that into this same Falcon tubes. So there is another 15 more ml water that is left. I will rinse all this properly and I will add the same also into this. So 30 ml of water using mechanical grinding, the first step is over. Now let me set the apparatus for the homogenizer and then let me show you how does it work. So now you can see, with the help of a burette stand, I have set this homogenizer and I have connected it to the power supply. So this fungal extract in this Falcon tube, I have kept it over here. There is speed adjustment also, so make sure that you keep the speed at lower speed itself. So now there is speed from 2 to 10, 2 to 4 is fine enough. So for this Falcon tube to stand, I might keep one beaker inside this. Just for to show you this, how it works, let me just remove this and show you as of now. You can see when I keep the speed, it rotates over there. So the lower portion rotates so that all the extract gets mixed properly. So I'm just going to insert this and I'm going to keep it. So I hope you can see it. It is, everything is getting mixed properly over here. So this is how a homogenizer works. So it has different speed. 4, 6, 8, 10. So this is of the higher speed. We will not usually keep at higher speed. 2 to 4 is fine. So this is off. Yes. So at this speed, I am going to leave it for 15 minutes. Then I am going to give a break for 5-10 minutes. Then again another 15 minutes like this. For 30 to 45 minutes I am going to do. So let this run like this. After this I will show you. We have to just. So after this what we are going to do. I am going to pour this into a conical flask. And I am going to keep it in the shaker. And leave it for overnight for 24 hours. And then next day I am going to centrifuge it. When I centrifuge I will get a clear supernatant solution. That is my fungal extract. So I am going to label it properly. Concentration, which organism, when it was prepared, what media was used, all those things I am going to label it. And then I am going to store it at 4 degrees Celsius or 0 degrees Celsius you can store it. So this is all friends how we prepare a fungal extract. I hope this video was very useful for you. If you like this video do give a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and do share with your friends. Thank you.